I'm Takeshi Osawa, again with the JEVI. I would like to thank for the supporting this workshop. Thanks for the member of JEVI, Ministry of Environment, Taibi. I'm very happy to take up a presentation today because I'm a student of Taibi on this topic. Before starting my talk, I would like to show my experience on biodiversity informatics. As Dr. Shao said in the opening remark, Taibi organized a workshop on biodiversity informatics in 2012. I joined this workshop, and this is the first time to learn about the GBI protocol, in specific IPT and data paper. After back to Japan, I tried to publish the data paper for my data. Fortunately, I successfully to publish data paper in 2013. After that, Taibi again organized a workshop on open data. Also, I joined the maker presentation for experience on data paper. So all of you can back to your lab and make a data paper in theory. And next year, you can make a presentation on your experience in here. And next year, you can take a presentation as a lecture. Anyway, I'd like to talk about my experience. So I focus on the publishing biodiversity data. So I want to provide you the overview on publishing biodiversity data. It's a little difficult to understand, so I would like to show briefly. This is today's talk on I have four topics. Firstly, I would like to introduce myself and motivation, show the motivation on biodiversity science. The second, I would like to show what is a data publication, published biodiversity data. Published paper, published report is it's relatively easy to understand for you. But published biodiversity data is a little strange, I think. So I would like to show what is published biodiversity data and why should we publish biodiversity. Then I would like to what is benefit on published biodiversity data. And finally, how to deal your biodiversity data. Okay, let's start my self-introduction. I'm Takeshi Osawa, working with the JEDIF. And officially, I'm working with the National Institute for Agro-Environmental Sciences. It's an agricultural institute in Japan. So my specialty is biodiversity informatics. But I'm not informatist, but basically plant ecologist. So my research is based on the biodiversity informatics, but our focus is the ecology. This is an illustration of my work. In the everyday, I am collecting the natural history records such as specimen, checklist, and observation record by amateur, and integrate that in other words, digitize, following the standard format, as Dr. Wang mentioned, Darwin Core, and make a database is biodiversity database. Using this database, I conducted ecological research, especially focused on broad scale, such as landscape to macro scale. So we call dry research, dry ecology. Do you know dry research? We often call wet research the field work. Dry research is lab work or computational work. So I'm a dry researcher using the biodiversity database. So I would like to show my representative research, two researches. Using database, database is not only biodiversity data, also the land use data. I published, evaluated the relationship between agricultural land use and threatened plant species using database. This is I established a distribution record on 23 threatened plant species based on the database. And I established agricultural land use. This is the intentional agricultural land use, modern agricultural land use. I found that exclusion relationship between modern agricultural use and threatened plant species. On the other hand, I established a map on agriculture abandoned area. I evaluated these relationships and find the overlap relationship distribution of threatened plants and agriculture abandoned land. This is one case study based on the biodiversity database. So if you have interest, please contact me later. I can provide you PDFs. This is an example of my dry research. But background is plant ecology, especially focused on the field work. So I love field work. So I often, not often in this way, visit the field and collect the plant and insect record. And using this for ecological research. But in this sense, in such situation, I used not only field record, also database. So I often call dry wet hybrid research. So I would like to show my represented research concept. I'm a half informatics, so I can make a simulation program. This is an example of that. I make a species expansion simulation program and conducted this. This is one of the area invader species in Japan. By species and shell species. I predicted, using this program, I predicted the expansion process on these species and evaluated that using field work, field and distribution record based on field work. This is the representative research on hybrid dry wet research. Anyway, my research is strongly related to biodiversity data or database. This is one of the important motivations to join such activities for me. So next, I would like to show what is the published biodiversity data. Okay, first of all, I would like to take you a question. What is our work? I think all of you, many of you are researchers and many of you are information managers. So as a researcher, our work is a research itself. As an information manager, our work is a data management. So next step, to finish the research, we should write a paper or report as a researcher. Also, we should release a new data or database as an information manager. We can call all publication. So please focus on the word publication. Publication include public. So we should be public on our achievement on as a researcher or as an information manager, at least on governmental employee like me. After publishing the achievement, this can contribute next work, such as new research or such as new databases. For example, if you publish your research achievement, paper, and database, you can contribute, that work can contribute to global issue. For biodiversity science, we should focus on the Aichi biodiversity target. In Aichi biodiversity target, there are 5 individual targets. So to contribute this target, we should provide the knowledge, not the experience. Knowledge issues should be published by as a research paper or a data paper, include data paper. Of course, we have the more specific requirement. Do you know, all of you know, as you know, IPBES. IPBES is basically the review work on current research, on current knowledge. So to contribute IPBES, we should publish data, publish research paper or publish data. Not only the global issue, also we can contribute local issue with a publication. This is one of the famous research project in UK, conservation evidence. Conservation evidence is focusing to the only local issue, not the global, not the regional issue, only focus local issue. Conservation evidence project have a paper, published paper named Conservation Evidence. Once we or researcher submit and accept the conservation evidence, if a project manager includes that knowledge, stores this knowledge in this website, practitioner or next researcher can download this knowledge with publication, with reference. This is one of the important case study on local issue with publication. If you don't open or publish the data, it's almost the same as a non-existent. And there are many cases in the in local issue. Oh, I know, based on my experience, based on my knowledge. It's actually part of, it's provide a very good suggestion or hint for the practical work, but it's difficult to use for broad scale. This knowledge can use only local people. So we should publish our research or data for publication. So previous two speakers take this image. This is a map on data distribution of data, biodiversity data in GIB. We can get this map. Published biodiversity data in Asia is regionally, in Asia region, very limited. I'm here. Focus before. Okay. If we focus the Asian region, we can find the many of dark area. Bright area have many biodiversity data. Bright area have many biodiversity data. If we focus the small this island, Taiwan has very good work among the Asian region. Yeah, anyway, we should make more collaboration on biodiversity data, publish biodiversity data. In summary, data publishes duty or responsibility on biodiversity researcher and information manager, at least governmental employee. Data published is almost the same as published paper or report. But in Asian region, published biodiversity data is limited. So we should make more collaboration. In this workshop, it's a very good chance to make more collaboration work, Next is, what is the benefit of publishing biodiversity? Collecting data. In other words, field work, data management, it's a dry work. As you know, it's a very tough, hard work. For example, field worker like me stay in the desert island, non-human island, for 1 week with a tent and collecting the species distribution and collecting several specimens. It's a very interesting but very hard work, as you know. In other side, information manager stay the day and night in their computer, laptop, or workstation. And to take and find the bug and fix the bug and provide data cleaning, several hard work. As you know, in both of them are too hard work, not easy work. So some people take to release open data. My data is mine. Why should I open? It's a mine. This is a typical case in ecologist. Typical Japanese ecologist. It includes previous me. Now I'm not take such a strategy. The other side, some people take a cheap strategy. Only use, not open. I want to use your data, but I don't open my data. This is a typical cheap strategy. But as I said, data management, data open, collecting data is a tough work. So many of them select this type of strategy. So to overcome this problem, we need the benefit for data publication. So this is one very good solution, data paper. I would like to introduce briefly. On day 3 to 2, I would like to take a lecture on how to submit data paper, how to manage data, how to write data paper. But today I would like to introduce briefly. Data paper definition is biodiversity data. Not focus on biodiversity data, but today I will focus on biodiversity data. Biodiversity data itself with scholarly publication. In other words, as you know, journal have several topics or types of article, original article, review, opinion, opinion, short communication, or something like that. So data paper is one of the topic or type of data of journal. This is my data, one of my data paper. Category is data paper. So user, you can use this data with citation, by citation, almost the same as a site as a site for the research article. So contents of data paper is data with a manuscript on description of data. Description is a study target, what species. Who collected me or other workers, and purpose of this research, collecting data, collection method, such as trapping, sweeping, by hand, etc. Yes, this is called metadata, description of data. Data paper is a description of data with data itself with description of data. These are almost saying the Darwin Core Archives, as Dr. Wang mentioned. So, biodiversity science, the biodiversity informatics scientists can make a data paper relatively easy because this is both of this same way, almost the same way. So aim of data paper is promoting, there are three main points. Promoting existing in other words, sleeping data set. Many of you, including me, have an old computer. When I was a student, I used such a computer. Inside this computer, field data. When I was an undergraduate student, or when I was a master course student, it don't publish. So more elder people have the field notes, writing a paper, writing by yourself. This have many of field records. That said, I found this species, I found this tree, like that. But they are not published. In other words, sleeping. So sleeping data, finding sleeping data, and published data paper. So published data paper can use anyone. So anyone who have interest in this data can cite and use this data and take a new research and publish new original article or new data paper. So this is a very good data cycle. So data paper is promoting finding or sleeping data. And data promoting data reuse. So this is act as an incentive for data publisher, data provider. No, this is my case. I already mentioned, I published data paper in 2013. So I found, this is a very good incentive for me. And after that, I published another data paper. This is the example of three data paper. But the data paper itself is not finished data paper. Of course, we can use this data paper by myself. So this is the original article written by me using this data paper. So I published data paper. After that, I can use this data with a citation on data paper. And I conducted new original research. This is a very good data cycle. So please follow me in this strategy. This is very good because if you have one research project, typically you can publish one or two research paper. But if you publish more data paper, you can get three or more paper. This is a very good achievement for researchers. So also, as I already said, data paper is one category of paper. So we can get a citation number. with more, if anyone who have interest in the site that use this data. So this is one very, very famous data paper. Incorrectly, this is not data paper, but almost the same data paper. Do you know the World Clean Database? If you know, please take a hand. Some of them will know. World Clean Database is a global climate layer covered all over the world. This data, this is freely downloaded with citation. This data, this paper is published by Hijman et al. In 2005. This, the citation number of this paper is, oh, sorry, more, sorry, this is a very small character. Over the 8,000 citation number, more, currently more than 8,000. It's a very, very high number. So if you provide a very, very high usage data paper, you can get a very, very high citation number. It's a very strongly connected to the evaluation of evaluation for research, your research. So in summary, data collection, data management are very, very tough work. So you need some benefit for data provide, data publication. Data paper is one of the influential solutions. So I would like to show in the next tomorrow or day after tomorrow in detail. So finally, I would like to how should we deal on your biodiversity data? For of course, this is a very strongly related to the open data. So answer is very simple. You should publish data as open data. Data paper, we ask open data with license, open data license. This is a very good solution. But as already know, GBIF released all data as open data. Open data, detail of open data is introduced by Dr. Wang. But in short, open data is free use, with free license and redistributed. GBIF is fulfilling this requirement. But open data is defined by the one of the large NGO, non-governmental organization, Open Knowledge Foundation. Open Knowledge Foundation take a definition of open data. I would like to read out. A piece of content or data is open if anyone is free to use and distributable, is subject only, at most, to the requirement to attribute and the or share alike. In short, as I said, open data requires three contents: free access, free copyright, and redistributable. If your desk can fulfill this requirement, this is open data. Free access is a little difficult to understand. You can get several data and several software in the internet. You can download freely, but it's not always free and open. Because this data we can download only, you cannot use. This is, this is a Japanese case. For example, you can get a free software, but you cannot see the source code. So this is protected by intellectual property. So free access is not every time equal or free. This is one of the important points. Next day two or day three, we would like to show what is open data more detail. So to overcome this protect or regulation, copyright is very important. Data owner is a copyright. Copyright is automatically attached to the provides some data or software like that. But sometimes this copyright is prevent the usability. So we would like to recommend the using license, open data license. As Dr. Wang mentioned, Creative Commons and the public domain. This is a very simple solution to attach open data, open license. But public domain is not good, I think, because public domain don't require the citation. like a data paper. So if you publish a data paper, my recommendation is attach a license, Creative Commons, CC BY. So CC BY is strongly related to the open data. So CC BY is a very good solution as an open data license. So if you have, you want to release data as an open data, very simple solution is attach Creative Commons, CC BY. What CC BY SF? CC BY are several types. So if you have an interest, please check the CC Creative Commons website. You can find the detailed description on that. Anyway, you can, if you want to publish the data as an open data, attach CC BY is a very easy solution. Next, redistributable is very important. If you attach an open data license, redistributable is already clear. But this redistributable is what is redistributable? Answer is if I get the open data and I manage to change, arrange, improve the data. After that, I can release this engineered data. This is a redistributable. So this is a very important point as an open data. Also, this is a desirable option. So data, if this data is open, but if that data, format of data is very, very unique, it's difficult to use for others. So this is a requirement point. For high usability and accessibility, data providers should use the standard data format. And standard data format which can use under the common data platform. In this perspective, biodiverse data, GBIF is very good, GBIF provides a very good solution. As Hosea-san and Yuhan explained before, GBIF have a data standard, Darwin Core and Ecological Metadata Language. And GIF to data file and data format, Darwin Core Archives. We would like to show in detail from this afternoon. So GBIF provides data standard, already provides data standard. Also, GBIF provides a common data platform, data management system named IPT2, Integration Publication Toolkit version 2. I would like to show and explain that in detail tomorrow. So GBIF provides not only the standard data format, also a standard common platform under the open source project. So you can learn about this workshop during this workshop, data standard, Darwin Core. What is Darwin Core? How to make a Darwin Core file? And common platform, IPT2, how to use, how to install, and how to publish data. And after that, as the open data, how to publish, how to submit data paper for academic journal. From this afternoon, we should show in detail. So in summary, that should be released as open data for availability. Creative Commons license is one of standard open data license. So we recommend you to use Creative Commons license if you want to release data as open data. So on biodiversity data, there are many standard data format standard and common platform. So we would like to introduce the common platform data standard from this afternoon. Okay, thank you for listening. We have more 10 minutes. So. But this is very lucky because we have a 20 minute discussion time. Again, thank you.